Alright, I started mine.
Alright, mine just started too.
Alright, I'm too lazy to actually do an intro.
I'll do a small intro for mine. This is Factorio, this is my little brother, Vag Dude. We're gonna try and give this game a shot. We played it a couple times. I got over 100 hours.
How many times have I told you just say Vac?
Whatever, I have Vac Dude. I gotta make a pickaxe.
Anyways, for those of you who don't know what this game is, it's called Factorio. It's basically a game that's your only goal is, or your final goal in this free play mode, is you're trying to get to space and basically just trying to automate everything. That's like the, that's basically what you do in this game. You just automate every last thing you can. So we actually got a pretty good spawn here. You know, we have a lot of trees, got coal, iron, copper, and stone. So yeah, like my brother said, we've played this some before, so we kind of know what we're doing. But it was a while back that I actually played this game. Alright, so I'm gonna come up here and mine some coal myself. No, is this
game? Game starts out pretty slow.
Yeah, it takes some time to pick up, but once you start automating, you can pretty much automate just about everything. Except for things you can't automate, obviously.
I'll probably not be making a series out of this gameplay, but I'm just glad I recorded while he's doing it for his channel. So now the manager is just clearing out space and getting some basic resources up.
Yep.
I've already set up our first tech to research, but we can't do that yet. You can actually access that menu by pressing T.
Yeah,
if you don't know or are just not playing this game. And you can go through the different techs as you see what I'm doing. I've already selected this one for research. You just click on it and then it'll select it.
Yeah.
You can just back out with escape or T.
Yeah, that's what I judged. I just pressed T.
So instead of going through and making a bunch of automated stone and stuff, I think we should just rush power right away.
I think we should try and, well, for power we need a lot of iron, so we might want to try and automate just the iron rather quickly.
Well, I'll let you work on that. I'm going to work on getting some power up.
Alright, I'll try and get the conveyors.
You have a couple different options you can do. There's some very easy ways to automate stone. I'm sorry. Automate coal production and do everything the old-fashioned way.
Yeah.
But the easiest thing to do is just to quickly get power up and running, so you don't have to worry about that. You just kind of get to skip that stuff if you do it quick enough. This is not really meant to be a tutorial, so if I would decide to make one, I'll do each step individually for you guys.
Yeah, because that's what you do. It's your plebby tutorials. Alright. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and mine up your furnace that you placed. Alright, so what I actually wanna do here first is let me come grab some more iron.
So I've got two.
Should I even bother with burner inserters, Chase?
Do I?
Because we can't even do power, so I might as well.
Where did my furnace go?
There you go.
Mm-hmm. Messing with my stuff.
So these will actually automatically put coal in themselves. Hey, Chase, I'm trying to automate here.
Yeah, but I'm not worried about it right now.
Nasty.
Because it'll take coal and put it in here, period. So you just take the coal out of here instead of putting it on that track. I mean, I know it'll automate this, but we're about to have powers up at the moment.
Really? How are you making power already?
Well, I've already got the two boilers. I just need to pump into steam.
Oh, jeez. I didn't know you already had all that.
I just need some more iron, so any iron you get, if you want to pass it to me, that'd be cool.
What is it to place things on the ground? What button is it? Is it all? There's a button you can press to actually drop things on the ground.
I need like a total of 60 iron.
Chase, do you remember what that button is?
9045. What?
It's Z. Okay. When you hold something out, press Z to drop it. Okay, now what was that button?
And then you hold F to pick
it
back
up. Alt? Yeah, that's Alt. There we go.
That's all.
Yeah, you hold F to pick things off of conveyors and whatnot. Alt is
I'm
kind of
stealing from your...
That's fine. I'm just trying to make some conveyors. We don't have any copper.
I need 19 more. I've got 6 copper.
Oh.
So I just need 19 more, so I'm just going to be stealing some iron from you until I get...
can't even use the normal inserters, though.
Yeah, what we did is pretty, actually pretty easy. You can press M to access the map and take a look around the general area, see if you got any enemies starting out. This lighter area over here is the area where we actually can see actively. This other area is kind of like a light fog of war, and then the blacked out area is we have no clue what's there.
Yeah.
So anything can be happening in these grayed out areas or darked out areas. Them we just don't know about.
And one of the nice things about this game is when you're crafting something, it'll craft everything else. So in order to craft that burner inserter, for example, I needed a furnace. Well, instead of having to craft the furnace, it just auto crafts it in the process, and it's really nice.
So I need to make some pipes.
I chose your coal drills out of coal. Alright, I'm gonna pick these up actually. Come back down here to copper. Alright, now I got copper automated. Roughly. Got your pump and all that, yeah.
Wait, now I have power, which means if you'll move, you're in the way. Remember, we want to set it up where it's on a loop, so we can make those curve back out this way.
Does it really need to be on a loop, Chase?
Yeah, because a priority for coal, and then the rest of the coal can go to the other.
Okay.
So, if I have any wood or coal, I'll put it in there to get it. There, I got some wood. So, I'll do that to get the system
press
started.
Press R to rotate things. Now, when you place it on a corner, it'll auto-do the bends thing. Oops. So, it's gonna save me a little bit of time, guys, so you'll probably see me pull up the wrong menu a lot. Just saying.
So, I need 23 more iron.
For
and
what?
Then I can get us so I can get a actual what's it called? Mine. Electric mine. Sorry, I had to think about it for a second.
I don't really need an electric mine for the time being though.
It'll allow us to get some iron faster. And then if you want to get some stone though, we can get some more furnaces going while I'm working on the iron.
Yeah, might as well. You know, as much as we fight and bicker, we actually work together very well.
I would say, see if you can get about, because we already have two furnaces, see if you can get about six more. That'll get
three
us about
correction.
Eight. How do we have three out right now?
Yeah, I have copper as well. So that we can get the inserters. Thought I'd make
okay.
The,
Well, then just make a 7, 8, 9, so... I don't know. We'll just make about 7 more furnaces, yeah.
No, I'm gonna make 5, so we have 8.
Oh, I was gonna say more than 8, but that's fine. No. Alright, I got our first,
Alright, I just made 5 furnaces.
Maybe give you somewhere to set that up in just a second. So I have movies over here.
Man, I'm so close.
Alright, so that does work. Alright, so I'm moving this.
Okie dokie.
Do you have any conveyors?
Yeah, I'm gonna dig up just some of these for the time being. Because we'll be able to get it faster if we set this up.
I don't have any. I don't have that much copper. Do you have some copper to make some of the regular inserters?
Yeah, and I also have the copper thing down there, so.
You might pass me the inserters and furnaces, because I do have a...
I don't actually have any inserters, I haven't made any myself.
Oh, okay. You just have the copper. Well, can you hand me the furnaces?
I can place the furnaces, Chase.
Yeah, but you placed them one by one. Like, side by side, sorry. I'm gonna say side by side.
And? Something wrong with setting it up like that?
Mm-hmm.
What?
I'll show you in just a second. Once I get some iron to actually make the inserters, I'll show you.
I've never had any problems setting it up like that, though.
No, it works. I just have another way that makes it a little more efficient. There's a couple different ways you can actually do it. I'm not going to do it the most efficient way, I'm just going to do it the way that
Well, yeah, we only have the one electric drill for the time being, so.
Yeah.
So, for now, we just need automation.
Yeah, and I can automate these first, too. I do need a little bit more wood and copper, though.
Yeah, I should grab some wood, since I haven't grabbed any at all. Alright, there we go. But seriously, what's the problem having them side by side?
Let's see. Do you have any copper on you still? Oh, no, I have a little bit.
No, but remember, there's
that right there. Down below. Now every single one of those will have power.
Alright, alright.
Yeah. And then, if I get a little bit more iron, we'll need to put some fuel in here first. Actually, some conveyors so that I can make. Because we want the coal output to come back around. Okay.
What I was just gonna do is bring it down, Chase.
Do what?
Just bring it down here.
Well, we wanted to run by this first. Remember?
Oh, right.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. That's what I'm working on right now. I just need a little bit more metal so I can get it, or a little more iron so I can actually make it.
Damn, I need iron. No, why do I need... Why did I make that? I just need iron. Because I can make... A little bit of iron? There we go. Because I can just do this. What does this cost? Just a ton of iron. I don't have another one, but... Alright, let's... Set that like that.
Alright, it's set up now.
Okay.
So if you see what I did here, the iron output's on the bottom part of the track,
yeah.
And now the coal output's on the top of the track. I'm letting people watching the video know too. This way, you can grab coal and iron from the same track, and it won't clog up.
Two main things of this game, efficiency, and automation.
Yep, right now, iron production is pretty much fully automated. The only problem is now there's going to be a backup on the output, which I can fix in a second. Instead of wasting a bunch of conveyors, I'm just going to place some containers. One thing to keep in mind, though, the more automation you create, and the bigger your factories get, the more pollution you'll create, and the
which
more enemies
will
be drawn to. Yep. I have my game set up to when I turn info screen on by pressing Alt. You can see on my map right here, this little red.
That
like
red is
fog.
Pollution.
I guess you could call it, that's pollution right there. And when you also turn the info screen on, you can see outputs and what's inside of the inventory of an item right now. Like these have iron in it, and it shows you. This one doesn't have any iron in it.
Yeah, for the time being, we just need to try and,
Next thing to do is copper, and copper's right down there, so that makes it even easier. We got really lucky with this.
Yeah, we got extremely lucky, and this was the first map as well, guys. This is the first map I created. I just created it, and this is what happened.
Yeah, I got really lucky on this one. I wish you would've put in a seed, and that way we could've memorized it. Maybe we can find the seed somewhere in a config file.
No, you can just put a seed in the game.
Mm-hmm. I'll figure it out. Like I said, the method we're using right now is not the most efficient, but it is definitely decently efficient.
It's there. It's, you know. You don't have to
keep everything really organized. I don't have another furnace. Do you have one?
No, the other furnace is down there at the copper.
Okay.
Which you can go grab if you so desire.
I'll probably grab it in a minute. Yeah. Because we don't really need that one up there, do we? Or wait, is it up here or is it down there? It's down here.
Okay,
So we pretty much skipped what I like to call the Stone Age, even though we're still using stone furnaces.
Yeah. We skipped the part of the automating stone drills.
Yeah.
We said screw stone drills, basically.
And legend is messaging me.
Is that why your phone's going be-de-de-de-de?
No, I don't know why my phone was going like that. Somebody's texting me also.
I'll grab the iron and make an iron chest. Why not?
He might join us here in a minute, so I'm telling him what we're doing.
There we go.
I think he has this game. I can't remember. He played this one, didn't he?
Yeah. Remember, he tried to do that bus thing.
The bus thing? That was Joey.
Was that Joey? I thought that was Legend. Oh, no, it was Joey, wasn't it? You have too many friends with all the same games.
Yeah. Which is actually what we're going to use once we get...
You know, most of which, because of you, and you never play those games. So.
Yeah.
See, you even admit it, that you make people buy games and, like, never play them.
Well, no, I play them, but I binge play them, and then I get tired of it.
You play it for, like, a couple days.
I have over 100 hours in this game. That's more than a couple days.
Yeah, and we restarted like 8 times because you were never satisfied.
Exactly. It's all about me.
Yeah, exactly. That's why no one likes playing with you.
Hey, you're the one who asked me to do this.
I said, do you want to? But this is also why I created the world, is so that I can play it, you know? And I don't have to wait
on
you.
I'm usually the one that runs the worlds, but he's the one that wanted to record, so I let him do it, and then I was like, you know what, hey, I'm going to start recording too. It's been over a year since I posted a video, so I was like, why not?
Alright, let's... Yeah, I still have like 3 hours till my first stream, so we're all good.
Yeah, he streams, I don't.
Because streams are amazing. So much easier. Okay, Chase, now I have to, my iron drills.
Okay, cool. I was just about to work on that. I'm gonna work on getting a copper set up as well. Actually, no, I'm not. First thing is, we need to get this first research done. Because if we get this first research done, I can make it where we have one furnace section that produces all metal.
How does a long-handed inserter?
Yep, that's all I need. And a lot of iron. So you have a lot of conveyors.
If you want to start working towards that, be my guest.
Say it again?
I said, if you want to start doing that, then be my guest.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to work on. Because now we have a little bit of power.
This iron's my iron.
This furnace is to make this copper.
Alright, one more electric mining drill. And for the time being, I'm putting them all on iron, because that's what we need. That's, like, all we need right now is iron.
Yeah, we need tons of conveyors for me to make the system.
Please don't put it on the wrong side. Hey? Hey! Alright, so now most of the furnaces should be active most of the time. Yeah, don't take iron from this chest, because this is the iron I'm trying to use down here.
Sorry.
It's alright.
I need like 36 iron, so.
Mm.
Which I just got, so. So I'm gonna make the science packs by hand for now.
Yeah. No point in automating it. Also, we can't automate it, so.
Yep, yeah, we have to get this first tech done.
Yeah, coal's all good. We don't need more coal for now. I have plenty of iron. What's our power at? Power's fine. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna try and make a crap ton of conveyors. Oh, right, you can right click and it makes 5, doesn't it? Yeah, right.
Alright, I have enough of everything we need to make the first tech.
Alright. I'm guessing this little area isn't gonna stay too long.
Nah, it'll probably be here just for a little bit. I wanna try and have about 4 mine drills on each section, so if you wanna work on making some more drills.
Electric ones?
Yeah, sorry. Actually, can you take one of those electric drills on the iron and bring it down here? Just so we can have it.
No, because we need iron.
Okay, well, I can make another thing.
Alright. It's just we need a lot of iron right now. That's like our main problem.
Okay, well, can you just make me another, go.
Yes, I can make you an electric drill. Bam, bam, bam. And... oh, whoops.
Nice.
Alright, we'll place it there. It's one block behind, or it's one... it's a little bit behind, but... it's good, because it... I guess right there would be...
nope.
I got this, Chase.
Mm.
Good enough.
You so wasted the watch us.
Hey, you can.
There you go. Now you can remove that one.
What do you ever? It worked.
Actually, I think I could put that directly into a container. I can't. Let me see if it does that.
Alright, let's... how long have I been recording, actually? 22 minutes.
How long?
20.
I thought you said 42. I was like, we've not been playing that long.
Dum-ba-da-bum. Alright, next, we probably want logistics for splitters and undergrounds.
Yeah. Let me see. Yeah, we want the splitters in the underground.
And how many is it? 4, 20?
20, yeah.
Yeah, now I just need copper.
Got a little bit of copper coming out through here. Now a big thing is gonna make a bunch of conveyors.
Alright, I'm gonna come up here and just yoink. Steal all that coal.
Alright, we're sitting at about half power production, so we have a little bit of upgraded space we can use.
Alright.
Pollution's gaining a little bit, but not bad.
Yeah. If we need to. See, we should build on the water when we get landfill. Build stuff on the water.
That sometimes can be kind of hectic.
Yeah, but it's also the safest way to do it, because it means there's only one entrance and one exit.
Well, I can't remember. Can you remove landfill? I don't think you can.
Mm-mm. Alright, I'm going to grab some fish.
Yeah, I forget you can do that.
There we go. I got a few fish. Oh, that's what it is. Oops. Okie dokie. Chase.
Hmm.
Why don't you just set something for this copper chest?
Because I'm about to.
Yeah, I set up stone just because I was sick of collecting it by hand.
I'm about to remove this whole entire area we're building.
That's fine.
Because I've got a system that, I've almost got all the parts we need.
Okay. I mean, I have 100 iron plates. I put half in the chest. So you can grab those if you need them. Alright, what am I...
I need a total of 20 regular inserters.
Block a 20 more.
And now I've got them set to craft. So I got 20 of those, 10 of those, and I got 50 conveyors, which is, sorry, 70 something conveyors. Or, sorry, almost 90.
I have 31 conveyors as well. I'm probably going to need to get another coal one, aren't I?
Might not hurt.
I need copper.
Alright, I'm removing everything, so...
do this like this. There you go.
If you want to pick up this stuff on the ground, you can. If not, I'll pick it up in a little bit.
Might as well.
Okay. So, now we need... I'm gonna make it in this direction even though there's a bunch of trees there.
We can clear out trees. Pain in the butt, but we can.
Yeah, we can learn a shotgun soon and maybe that'll make it a little easier.
Or a flamethrower.
Yeah,
that would be Chase, that's a very long way away.
I know. It's just one of the ways I'm doing it. Let's see.
Right.
If you want to go ahead and connect that middle one to the copper, just
you mean to
connect
the coal?
It from, yeah, sorry, connect it from right here though, from that, not from the, yeah, there you go. You can remove the altar line right there.
Yes, Chase, I know how to do it.
Iron come from. Don't connect it though. Leave like one block missing. I kind of did that.
There you go. The most pointless thing ever.
So the way we're setting this up right now is pretty self-explanatory. It's kind of just a really nice, simple, easy grid. These long inserters, though, will grab from the farthest away section.
No. We'll just go with that. Why not? I'm doing this because I want coal going on both sides of the line. At This is gonna be power hungry. Should I go add another steam boiler? Or steam engine?
We're sitting at like a quarter production of what we could be making right now, so we'll see what it does when I cut it on.
My god.
Alright, it's almost ready. Almost. Hold on. Do something special here.
Just want to find out, what would it be if I'm putting it? 23. Okay, if we're gonna go for each, then that's fine. I'll go ahead and move this one over here as well.
It's really on.
Son of a... Got it. And I can have the other one, right.
You'll redo a lot of your designs. That always happens.
What?
I'm just saying in general, a lot of designs are rebuilding over and over and over again.
There. I can do that.
Alright, everything's ready.
Perfect. I'm going to redo this iron real quick so that it's just more efficient. Bam.
So now the power grid's sitting at about half capacity.
Hold on. One second, I'm sorry. There we go. That's that. Is that really not reached that?
A little bit over half capacity.
God dang it. Whatever.
Did you finish what you were doing?
Yes.
So yeah, it's a little bit over half capacity. So if you want to go ahead and start working on another one, you can.
Working on another what?
Just if you add another steam engine, make sure you add another boiler.
Yeah, because if we're gonna add, yeah, because if we're adding, two more drills, electric drills, then yeah, we're gonna need another boiler and steam engine.
Alright, I'm gonna work on automating, you know, the science packs.
By the way, Chase, can't we have, like, isn't, like, 8 boilers enough to power, like, or isn't, like, is it, like, 12 boilers is enough to power 8 steam engines or something?
I'm not sure what the ratios are. I usually just do a 1-to-1 and call it a day. I think 4 can power 10, but don't quote me on that.
4 can power 10 boilers?
I think 4 boilers can power 10 steam engines, but don't quote me on that. Just do a 1-to-1 ratio for now.
Is that really not powered? Bloody heck.
Yeah, now we're sitting at in between less and right at half okay, production. What's the water level is at? What's the temperature of the water?
It's all good.
Well, I mean, what's the actual temperature?
99.
99, okay, yeah, we're good. Oh, this first one's only at 57%. That's weird, but no, as long as the boiler's all getting, you know, almost 100%. Or 100 degrees.
Okie dokie, alright guys, I'm actually gonna go ahead and end off the video there. We recorded this in like an hour long in total. I think it was about an hour long, so I actually just cut it in half, and I'm gonna upload it in two separate parts. This part, which is 30 minutes, and another part that's 30 minutes, and that's probably how most of the series will be, is recorded in long chunks, hours, you know, hours or 2 hour long chunks, and I'll just cut them up into 30 minute segments. And that's just kind of how I do it, but I hope you guys enjoy it. If you did, check out some other stuff, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.